Simple, straight.
I can't afford this life no more.
Just getting lucky. I'll give you a chance to win your money back.
You want in, boss?
We have business to discuss, Paulie.
We're in it now, boys.
One of our associates at the coroner's office sent this over. Corpse's name is Giolotti.
You recognize him?
Sure. That's one of the punks we ran out of the neighborhood.
Now he got the bullet in the back of his head?
Yeah. We capped him.
Well, the cops ought to thank us. We did him a favor. The guy was a rapist, boss.
Yeah? Well, he was also a city councilor's son. You want to drive a politician into Morella's arms? There's no better way than killing off his family.
Oh, Christ.
It gets worse. You left another guy in the wreck?
Yeah, but he was dead when we got there.
You gonna tell me he was the president's nephew or something?
Two in the head, Paulie. If you're gonna do a job, do it right.
He made it?
Yes. He spent the week in St. Mary's, but he pulled through.
Can he point a finger at either of you?
I don't know. Maybe.
Okay. Look, we're gonna kill two birds with one blast. Galati's funeral's today at St. Michael's. Sam, you're gonna attend. Sit in the back and try to spot the lucky bastard.
How will I recognize him?
He'll be the one who just crawled away from a car wreck.
His arm is broken. Look for a sling.
Sam's gonna need a little distraction if he's gonna clean up your mess.
Are you sending Tommy to dip his wick?
Is it brothel?
A gentleman's club, just down the street from St. Michael's. Madonna's invested a lot of money in it over the years.
So, me and Sam.
Regardless, the owner has suddenly decided to do business with Morello instead of us.
You want me to go remind him of his obligations?
Yes. Then blow the place up.
What?
Morello wants to take businesses away from us? He'll inherit craters.
Look, Tom, we can't send Paulie and Sam since all the ladies know them already. They'd never make it through the front door. But you can walk right in.
Okay. What about the manager?
Take care of him wherever you find him. If any of the horse see it, well, it'll be a warning. Once he's out of the way, head to his office on the top floor. Grab any documents and money you find there, and place the explosives.
Vincenzo will see that you have what you need.
And you think the blast will be big enough to give me cover?
Yeah. But be smart. Only take a shot if you know you won't get made.
Tommy, one more thing. One of the girls is passing Morello information about our operations. Before you blow the place, you'll need to take care of her, too.
You want Tommy to kill a twist? Come on, Frank.
It's just bad luck this falls to Tom. But we gotta protect the family.
Her name is Michelle. She's usually working one of the upper rooms. Her photo is in the folder.
You boys clear on everything?
Yeah.
Tom.
I got it, boss.
Then get it done.
Come on, let's go. Vinny, I'll meet you here.
I heard about their misfortune, Tom.
We're gonna fix it.
A lesson learned, I think, eh?
Heard you in the market for something that goes boom. Give those girls a squeeze from Uncle Vin, huh?
Not today, Vinny.
You remember when the Corleone Hotel was a classy joint? The cat house you're going to has been headed downhill since 29. Though, I guess the girls are still pretty.
We have to talk. Get in. Don't go anyplace yet. Gotta hear me out on this. It's about the girl.
Michelle?
Right. You don't have to rub her out. Just make her disappear.
You know her?
Yeah. I've been with her a few times. She's a good egg, Tom. Just maybe not so bright. She doesn't deserve to get plugged just because she likes listening to me talk.
You think she'll leave town?
When she understands what'll happen otherwise, yeah, she'll leave. Here's 100. Give it to her. And make sure she gets far away.
Okay, Sam. I'll see what I can do.
That's all I'm asking. Let's go.
Michelle. She's the one from the racetrack, right?
Tom, that was the last time we were ever gonna talk about her. Ever. I told you what I had to ask, and you listened. Gotta leave it there.
Okay.
Keep your head when you get into the hotel. Find your mark and don't act suspicious. The manager thinks he's untouchable. You can probably walk right up to him.
Anything else I should know?
Nah. Just don't take all day. Lottie died young, so there can't be much to say about him. When the bomb goes off, I'll do my thing.
Got it.
What kind of world is it that when you screw up, you get sent to a cat house? Well, I have to clean up your mess at a funeral. You see the justice in that?
I see a job I gotta do.
Such a professional. Just try to finish the job this time, huh? First time I've been to a church in a while.
Well, I'm gonna guess they're still singing the same songs.
Last time I went, it was. Same songs I always heard as a kid.
Yeah, you're not the religious type.
It's the funerals, Tom. That's all it ever is. All that anyone ever wants to do is point guns at the family and shoot. Game point, there were so many funerals, I just stopped going to most of them. They're all boring as hell.
That's a shame, seeing as you're always dressed for the occasion.
Great gag, Tom. Write that one down.
Thanks. I'll do that.
Now, weddings. Weddings are less boring. I'd go to one of them. You working on that?
Guess so.
Good. Because I've given up waiting on Polly. Guy couldn't get a broad to stick to him if they went swimming through glue.
He'll find someone.
Tom, if his own mother has given up hope, then you can give up hope, too.
Here's your stuff.
I'll give the family your condolences.
Good luck.
You too.
You behave yourself in here, okay?
Know where I can find the manager?
I just watched the door, pal.
Hey, handsome. You here for a girl, drinks, or a mix of the two?
A girl. And I got some business with your manager, too.
A girl I can help you with. Come through. Find a girl you like, and you can both get better acquainted upstairs. There's no rush, so get a drink, relax, and enjoy yourself.
Hey, good afternoon, sir.
Come through when you're ready.
I need to talk to the manager.
Yeah, head straight through to the lounge. You're with our new business partners, I assume.
Know a girl named Michelle.
Hey, the only girls I know are the ones behind you, sir. And the only ones available.
I need to speak to Michelle.
The only girls available are the girls you can see. Find one you like and don't make a fuss.
Get a guy, not before.
Fine.
You know the rules, Dottie.
Is Michelle in today?
Let me check. She's in, but she's busy. If you're waiting for Michelle to come down, she ain't gonna. She's got fellas in with her all day long. Downtown 1702.
I can't come in. Johnny's sick.
He don't care. He wants you here.
I need to take him to a doctor.
Is he dying?
No, I don't think.
Then it don't matter. You need to come in. Leave him with the lady next door if you need to.
I can't do that.
You're his best girl. And he says he wants you here to entertain the new guys he's getting protection from. It don't matter how sick your kid is. You gotta... rest of the girls in the corner 6 and Maple, then be my guest. You told me what it was like. Fur coat and flashing the cars look when there's snow at your feet and you can't feel your legs for the wind and cold. I'm doing you a favor. Your kid'll get better. But you're working on the street.
These new guys getting the run of the place.
And a manager having to play nice with his new friends.
How come?
I'll cover. It's when your new friends turn up with Tommy guns.
I'll leave it to you.
That's what you do.
Bye.
Friendship between the Corleone Hotel and the Morello family be long and fruitful.
Can I help you?
Thank you.
Right there! He's up! Let me in! Taking cover!
You, Michelle?
What's it to you?
Fella named Sam is one of your regulars.
Maybe there's a lot of guys named Sam.
You know him. Works for Don Celieri. Maybe you got him talking about our business from time to time, and maybe Don Morello offered you some money to spill what you heard.
No, Sam, trust me. I don't say nothing. He knows that.
But the Don's losing a lot of money because someone can't keep their mouth shut.
I was just bumping guns with some of Morello's girls. I didn't mean nothing by it. Tell him I'm sorry. Tell him I won't never open my mouth again.
Shh. I know.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You scared then? Good. Don't you ever forget how it feels to be this scared. To know you're just one twitch away from a hole in the ground. Because if you ever show your face in this town again, they're gonna find you with 2 in a head. Do you understand? Lucky for you, Sam's got a big heart. Get dressed and make tracks. This place is gonna blow soon.
Thank you.
Just don't come back and we're square.
Drop you off. It's not what it looks like.
Ah, sorry.
Got him! Reloading! Oh, killed him! Oh, Christ! found you! Gotcha!
No matter how far we've fallen, we can find redemption in death.
Now, William, he was a sinner, yes, but
he was also a loving son, a protective brother, and a loyal friend. And for those virtues, we pray that his soul will find salvation. And now, I believe one of Billy's closest and dearest friends would like to say a few words.
Thank you, Father. I just wanted to pay my respects. Billy, I never said this, but I consider you my brother. I can't even count all the times you saved my ass from a beating. So I don't know how I'm gonna—
What are you
doing? Wait, that's the guy. That's the guy who killed Billy!
Please! Andrew,
this is what was really involved
over
in!
Over here! Come in here!
Get this guy off me!
Molotov!
Get him off me!
I'm enjoying this!
What have you done? Murder in the house of God!
These men were criminals, Father. Thieves. Rapists. Killers.
And God would have embraced them if they'd asked for forgiveness. Now, which one of these men might have sought redemption by working with the poor? Which one might have saved just one life?
None of us, Father. You bastard. If you have any confessions to make, you better do it quick.
No more bloodshed, please!
I'm sorry, Father. Consider this an act of divine retribution.
That make us even?
Sure. For now. For your trouble, Father.
I don't want your blood money.
You took theirs. Not a lot of difference from where I'm standing. That should be enough dough to patch up the bullet holes and keep you quiet.
When the cops come, you tell them the gunman who did this had East Coast accents. Must have been from out of town, right?
I won't lie. But I won't say anything at all.
Good. Be a shame if we had to come back here.
Where the hell were you?
As soon as I walked in the church, the crew recognized me. Followed me straight back out.
Where are they now?
The same place as all these guys. Come on, we gotta go.
First aid here.
Form a perimeter around the church, boys. Don't let it out.
In the hearse, let's go.
Are you kidding?
It's got wheels, don't it? Unless you can not find another. Sure. But we got cops everywhere. No going in now. Where the hell is that bastard hiding?
Today didn't turn out like I expected.
Got the cops plenty pissed.
Yeah, it was messy, but I got everything done.
Everything?
Yeah. Everything.
Forget today for a long time.
You tell.
Let's get back to the bar. We gotta lie low.
The way this all went down, we gotta lie low for weeks.
The priest will keep his trap shut. Don't worry. Morello got a bloody nose. We
You and Polly are in the clear for whacking Galati's son. Boss will be pleased.
You got a death wish or something?
Can't stand here forever, Tom.
Roosevelt's new field comes to Lost Heaven. Find out all about it.
Thanks again, Sam, for helping me out back there. I thought my time was up.
It's not anything you wouldn't do for me.
I know, but when you come that close to biting it, Christ, it's something.
Don't need to tell me about that. Just don't think about it. Best lesson I could ever teach you. Don't think about anything.